What's up, everybody? It's Rax the Gray here. So today I'm going to do something a little bit different. I've been a big fan of fighting games for a very long time, and one of my favorite things to do when it comes to fighting games is customize my own arcade sticks when I get them. So I'm going to go over a brief little overview of what you can do to take your boring fight stick and kind of make it your own. In this video, I'm going to show you the two fight sticks that I personally own, and that is going to be the Mad Catz Tournament Edition 2 fight stick and the HORI Fighting Edge. Now, I personally like the simplicity of the Tournament Edition 2 by Mad Catz, just for the simple fact that you can easily push a button in the front and pop it open to start your customization. So as you can see here, you have your main buttons and then you have your joystick area. So we're going to get into that in just a second. And for the sake of the video, I actually took the liberty of taking out the screws of the HORI fighting stick. And that way I can show you how you need to take off the bottom if you so happen to have one that doesn't pop open as simple as this one. So I personally like to label my buttons. That makes it a lot easier to remember the fighting style layout, or if you want to customize it later, say if you're playing a game that doesn't give you the option of remapping your buttons. I'm going to start out with the Tournament Edition 2 stick and just show you a couple different things that you can do, just because it's a little bit simpler to show you with this. Then I'll hop into the HORI stick, because it will be, you know, a little bit more in depth on how to customize maybe some of the other sticks that don't pop open so easily. So the first thing you want to know is the button size. Most of the fight sticks that you get, or arcade sticks if you want to call it, are gonna have a 30 millimeter push style button. So you're gonna want one that probably snaps in. Now, Sanwa is my personal favorite. I like to get the Sanwa buttons just because they're a little bit cheaper. They're, you know, arcade quality, and they really last a long time. So I personally go to a couple of different websites to get my buttons, and that would be Video Games New York and FocusAttack.com. So if you're looking for buttons, ball tops, different little arcade style pieces, you're gonna wanna go to those websites because they have the best options available. So when you get there, you're gonna see different styles of ball tops. I personally like the bubble styled ball tops. They're really, really nice looking, and they just are awesome. So as you're looking at this stick, you're probably noticing that I have three buttons on the bottom that are green, three buttons on the top that are green, and then two buttons over here that are a different color. The reason for that is because most fighting games use a 3-on-3 button style layout, and then these buttons will act as like either a block or a, you know, combination of the buttons together. So that's the reason why I have mine set up like this. You don't have to set it up like that, but I personally think it looks a little cooler as well. So when you are changing your buttons, you do want to be very, very careful. You want to remember which part is going where, and that way you're not taking, like, you know, a piece from here and sticking it over on this button. You really want to make sure that you are sticking with the setup that it has. So most of the wires are going to be color coordinated, but if they're not, you want to make sure to label them just like you saw on the other stick, so that way you're not messing up, because if you mess up, that could be very, very bad. Now, you want to be very careful when you take these off, because these are connected to your button, and that is really what's sending the signal to your fight stick slash arcade stick, whatever you want to call it, and you really don't want to have to mess this up. So if you mess this up, you're going to have to buy a whole new cable wiring system, and it's not that it's expensive, but who wants to spend extra money that they don't need to? All right, so let's talk about customizing the picture. So on the Tournament Edition 2 stick, you're gonna have to take off the ball top, you're gonna have to take out all your buttons, because this plastic layer does need to come off. So when you do that and you return and you remove all of your button pieces, you're going to unscrew each one of these screws. So once you've done that, the plastic layer on the top will pop up, and make sure that you put your screws in a safe spot so you do not lose them. Losing screws is not a good plan. Once you've removed the plastic layer from the top, you have a little setup where it's gonna have a piece of paper under there. I personally take that paper and trace it onto a larger piece of paper and then cut it to the size that I want. I personally have used a couple of different methods in making a custom picture. Now, I have used a clipping from magazines to make this Transformers background, which, you know, it's pretty basic, but I thought it was cool at the time. I'm planning on changing it out to maybe like a Venom or, you know, something like that to kind of go along with the Spider-Man stick that I have that's HORI. There are also a lot of different websites online that will offer you a different template. All you need to do is kind of type in, you know, Tournament Edition 2 Fight Stick template, and they kind of will give you the sizing and a, you know, template where you can customize your own. Another piece I want to point out real quick is the gate. So most of the time when you buy your fight stick, it's going to come with a four-way square gate. I personally like the octagon gate just because it gives you a little bit more of a range of motion, and it kind of gives you a little bit of a click too when you are kind of doing the down corner, left down corner, right kind of motions. It makes it a little bit smoother in my opinion. With the HORI stick, to get the glass off the top, you also still need to take off all the buttons and the ball top so you can literally lift the plastic. But on this one, you're gonna remove the different different screws on the top here. So if your stick has screws on the top, you're definitely gonna have to do it from the top, and you are gonna wanna take off the buttons from the bottom as well. So when you do that, you are going to push on the sides to remove the buttons out of the bottom. I don't want to do that in the video just because it's kind of a pain to get them back in. And to unscrew the ball top, you have to unscrew right here. So right there, you're going to take a flathead screwdriver, which is on most of them, and you're going to hold the ball top and unscrew here. Make sure you're keeping all of your pieces together because that is very, very important. On my HORI stick, I chose to go with a Spider-Man theme. And how I did this was, as I lifted off the plastic, underneath there was a peeper there, just like I was talking about before. And I took 70s comic books, Spider-Man obviously, and just glued them to the paper. If you take a glue stick, like an Elmer's glue stick, it goes right on there. And as you put it underneath the plastic, it's gonna give it that, you know, nice professional look. You don't need to go worrying about laminating it or anything like that. Another cool thing that you can do with your fight stick is actually add LEDs and things like that to your buttons. So in a second, I'll light these bad boys up and show you how that looks. But on this stick right here, the HORI Fighting Edge actually comes standard with two LED bars on the sides. And it's really cool because when you get hit, you will see a flash of red, but it normally lights up blue. But when you get attacked, or if you, you know, block or anything like that, it does flash red, which is a really cool feature. This one here, actually the LEDs will light up through the buttons, but it doesn't do any kind of flashing or anything like that. I just like the LED style buttons. But another really cool thing that you can do is buy different LED colors, different buttons, and you can customize it to the way you like it. Another really useful tool to have when you're, you know, using arcade sticks or anything like that is to have a Cronus Max Plus. This piece right here is a USB receiver, adapter, whatever you want to call it, that will basically make it where you can play any console controller on another console. Basically, so if I want to take this Xbox stick, for example, and play it on my PS3, PS4, whatever, I can take this piece right here, upload a program from my computer into the side here, and it will allow me to play any of my consoles with any controller. So if you're not big into fighting games, another great reason to have one of these is for those retro style downloadable games, or say you have a compilation disc, maybe like a Namco, or my personal favorite is the Sega Genesis collection, and I personally use these on some of the arcade games that were in those. Thank you guys so much for checking out this video. Make sure to hit the subscribe button so you can stay in touch, and make sure that you check out all the rest of the content on the channel as well. If you want to see some more videos like this, make sure to put it in the comment section and let me know what you guys think. Let me know what you want to see. So I can also do another video where I go more in depth and actually take one of these guys apart if you want to see that. So let me know. Thanks a lot, guys.